Hello everyone, thank you for joining me today. My name is Justin Pascal with RetireSafe, and today we will be discussing advanced directives and the specifics of setting yourself for the future, as well as your family. We will be talking about the specifics of advanced directives, how each state views and handles these directives, a living will, a durable power of attorney, and a healthcare proxy. We will also cover Alzheimer's and dementia, and palliative and hospice care. So let's look at some background on advance directives. What are advance directives? Well, advance directives refer to a written statement of a person's wishes regarding medical treatment, often including a will, ensuring those wishes are carried out should the person be unable to communicate them to a doctor. Having advance directives is essential for several reasons. First, directives can determine whom you want making decisions for you when you are physically or mentally unable to. Directives also allow you to express to your loved ones what you wish them to know, including how you want to be treated, such as you do not resuscitate, what treatments you approve of, and the level of comfort you prefer during your palliative or hospice care. When evaluating the different types of advance directives, it's easiest to break them up into three categories. First, we have a living will, which contains a document that leaves instructions for treatment. We also have a durable power of attorney who makes financial decisions for you, and a healthcare proxy who makes healthcare decisions for you. All three of these categories are important to keep in mind when constructing your advance directives. Another essential aspect of forming your advance directives includes researching your state's requirements and other states you may visit frequently. This is due to the different laws in each state. Some orders may or may not be honored depending on the state, such as laws surrounding your do not resuscitate orders. When constructing your will, there are five essential steps to keep in mind. First, you must proclaim your preferred treatment options. Second, you should assign a medical or durable power of attorney. Third, specify the living will to your state or states. Fourth, sign the will. And fifth, store and update the will as needed. Taking a more in-depth look at the power of attorneys and their roles, we can classify them into four categories. First, we have a general power of attorney who can perform almost any activity involving managing personal finances. However, the general power of attorney agreement is terminated when the patient or principal is incapacitated. Next, we have the durable power of attorney, which the principal assigns to act on their behalf for financial reasons. In this agreement, however, this clause maintains the power of attorney after the principal becomes incapacitated. Next, we have a medical power of attorney, limited to only making medical decisions for the principal rather than financial decisions. Finally, we have a springing or limited power of attorney, which occurs when an event triggers the agreement and is usually constrained to only specific abilities. Understanding the difference between a durable power of attorney and a healthcare proxy is essential when constructing your will. So here are some quick pointers to help you remember. First, a healthcare proxy makes all healthcare decisions for you when you can. They do not make financial decisions. States also have different requirements for signing the healthcare proxy form. A durable power of attorney, it makes all financial decisions for you. They cannot make healthcare decisions for you. If you want them to, they must sign a healthcare proxy form in order to do so. Alzheimer's and dementia are horrible conditions that can affect you as young as 30. That is why the best time to start looking into advanced healthcare directives is early on, before or when you start experiencing early signs of Alzheimer's and dementia. Here are a few examples. Memory loss that disrupts your everyday life, challenges in planning or solving problems, and difficulty completing familiar tasks. I can relate to this because my grandma, unfortunately, was diagnosed with Alzheimer's and thankfully was able to appoint my father as both a durable and healthcare power of attorney through her advance directives. This is just one example of why it is important to set your advance directives early on. Don't wait. Hospice and palliative care are also important to consider when constructing your directives. Your preferences regarding advanced care planning, caregiver support, and pain management can all be determined based on your directives. After viewing this webinar, here are some questions you can ask yourself. First, what is the difference between a durable power of attorney and a healthcare proxy? Second question, why is it better to set your advance directives early on rather than later? Here are the answers to the previous questions. First, durable power of attorneys control only your financial decisions, while healthcare proxies control only your healthcare-related decisions. Second answer, it is important to set your advance directives early in life because conditions like Alzheimer's and dementia can come about early, making it difficult for you to make those decisions later on. So it is important to have a will and a durable power of attorney, as well as a healthcare proxy if needed. We have come to the end of this webinar, and I hope you learned some valuable information and enjoyed the content. If you would like to contact us at RetireSafe, please use these references for any questions or concerns. Thank you again. If you would like to further your knowledge on any of the information we discussed here today, please click on these links in which we used to help create the webinar, one of which being www.caringinfo.org can help you determine your state's rules and regulations surrounding advance directives. Thank you again for listening, and have a wonderful day.